Many Christians are aware of the totalitarian inspired United Nations Agenda 2030, the plan to form a one world government. But many of these Christians have also rested in the fact that this agenda was still 9 years away. Well, guess what? This week, UN Secretary General Guterres released a new 73-page document, bumping up the plan to take power from the nations and form a one world government. And he bumped it up to 2023, just a little more than a year to a year and a half away. The reason? COVID, of course. Topics in this agenda are putting teeth in world governance, taking control away from the nations of the world and giving it to what they call thought leaders. It recommends worldwide health passports to force health decisions on every single person. It contains legal normalization of aberrant lifestyles and enforcement of the UN peace initiatives likely to take place in the Middle East and Israel. It is a nightmare for those fearing the end of the world. That's what we're talking about today, and we're starting right now. Of course, on this channel, we aren't fearing the end of the world as we know it, because at the end of that time, the time of tribulation, King Jesus will return and the world will be ruled in righteousness. Yes, we have to go through the great tribulation between now and then, but the end is glorious. God had King David prophesy about the days we are living in right now. Why do the nations rage and the peoples plot in vain? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, "Let us burst their bonds apart and cast away their cords from us." This is exactly what we're seeing right now with this new agenda. Never in history have the nations conspired in the way they are doing now. An anti-God, one-world government favoring sexual immorality, and a lack of national sovereignty. A return, in other words, to the days of the Tower of Babel, trying to make a name for themselves, not glorifying God. Trying to cast away the restraints of God's holy laws of morality and impose laws of immorality on a global basis. Think about that. The meetings and covenants of 2023 will be fulfilling Psalm 2 like nothing we have ever seen since David wrote those words, like nothing since the Tower of Babel when Nimrod ruled. But regardless of what they plot, here is why we are to be encouraged. He who sits in the heavens laughs, the Lord holds them in derision. Then he will speak to them in his wrath and terrify them in his fury, saying, "As for me, I have set my king on Zion, my holy hill." God, who sees the end from the beginning, holds these leaders in contempt. He will send his king and set him upon Mount Zion. That is Jesus, of course. He has a one-world government of righteousness coming, and Jesus will be the king. The psalmist continues, and this is Jesus speaking now. "I will tell of the decree. The Lord said to me, 'You are my son. Today I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will make the nations your heritage, and the ends of the earth your possession. You shall break them with a rod of iron and dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel.'" Here is the end of the story. Jesus crushes the one world government that the United Nations is trying to assemble, the one the Antichrist will eventually assume. The nations are Jesus's inheritance, not theirs. Now, we've been doing a series of videos on the UN, its health mandates, and its plan to take over control of the world. This document that was just released by the Secretary General summarizes all these things that we've been discussing and more. A link to the document from the UN is down in the description. Here is the statement from the UN at the beginning of a document that summarizes their view of our world today. Quote, "We are at an inflection point in history. In our biggest shared test since the Second World War, humanity faces a stark and urgent choice, a breakdown or a breakthrough. The coronavirus disease, COVID-19, is upending our world, threatening our health, destroying economies and livelihoods, and deepening poverty and inequities. Conflicts continue to rage and worsen. the disastrous effects of a changing climate. Famine, floods, fires, and extreme heat threaten our very existence. Obviously, the UN sees the world in very stark terms, requiring extraordinary actions. Actions that, of course, are going to benefit the UN's power grab, taking us from a world of nation states to one ruled by global billionaires in the UN. And the levers they plan to use to force this upon the world are pretty clear. In this statement, COVID and climate change are mentioned, both greatly overstated in their impact. In our channel's opinion, they are only excuses to take control of the world, and they will likely add other levers, possibly economics and war, to further force their agenda. But since these haven't happened yet, they're probably holding back any comments about them. But before we dig into the UN's new agenda and its details, none of which I like personally, let's review the ground we've already covered in recent weeks. In this previous video, we discussed how it is likely that a one-world government run by billionaires in the UN would be Mystery Babylon, not the Beast Empire. Let me say that again. A one-world government run by billionaires in the UN would likely be Mystery Babylon and not the Beast Empire. You can watch this whole other video when this one is done, or even click right here. The link to it is down in the description as well. However, let's keep going. In that video, in a nutshell, we said the Beast and Mystery Babylon are two different end-time entities. Many, if not most Christians, are totally unaware of this, that a one-world government is going to precede the Beast. Mystery Babylon initially sits on or controls the Beast, Revelation 17:3. This appears to be the stage we are moving into now. In fact, Mystery Babylon controls the kings of the world, Revelation 17:18. Then, after Mystery Babylon is in charge, the Beast and the 10 kings only then burn Mystery Babylon with fire, Revelation 17:16. Most Christians will see a one-world government form and instantly think it's the Beast Empire. But it isn't. Doesn't mean it's a good empire, but it isn't the Beast. A one-world Mystery Babylon government is going to come first. Watch the previous video to see more details on this. Also, Mystery Babylon's merchants are going to become great ones of the earth. What does this mean? To me, it seems to mean that they are going to become the rulers of this network or government of Mystery Babylon. And guess what? This is exactly what the UN is planning. Until just recently, this plan was pretty well disguised and hidden. But now, they are out in the open about this plan. Here is a direct quote from the World Economic Forum's president, Klaus Schwab, from his book, Global Redesign. Quote, "A globalized world is best managed by a coalition of multinational corporations." Really? Did you hear that? "Governments through the UN system and select civil society organizations." It argues that governments are no longer the overwhelming dominant actors on the world stage, and that the time has come for a new stakeholder paradigm of international governance. In the agenda published last Friday by the UN, they are planning an advisory board of stakeholders to suggest the new form of world governance to implement this common agenda. Sounds just like what Schwab was talking about. The UN calls these people thought leaders. They are also planning a stakeholder summit of the future to vote on this new governance. And this stakeholder summit is planned for 2023. Interestingly, former heads of government are a major suggestion to be included in these thought leaders. Who might that be? The first name that came to my mind was Barack Obama. Who else might be included in the thought leaders? Bill Gates comes to mind as well, and maybe some of the other global billionaires. Are these Mystery Babylon's merchants and great ones? Perhaps. We will see, but it seems kind of likely that they might be. But the very name thought leader really disturbs me. I do not want my thoughts led by anyone. In Revelation 18, we learn that these merchants of Mystery Babylon become the great ones specifically because of something known as their pharmakia, and that's Revelation 18:23, their pharmaceutical sorcery. This document we've been looking at today discusses this aspect in more detail. The UN is calling for a global vaccination plan to tackle what they call, quote, the serious problem of vaccine hesitancy, unquote. They state that part of the way they want to do this is to increase the independence and authority of the World Health Organization. Imagine increasing the authority of the corrupt WHO. Not what any of us listening to this would want or choose, I would think. Bill Gates and the WHO have just this month already designed a global health passport that we reported on in this previous video. Again, the link to learning more about the global health pass and global mandates is down in the description. The UN is also calling for universal health coverage, including mental health, in all countries, allowing government control of healthcare decisions on a worldwide basis. All of these healthcare initiatives are major levers, if you think about it, for totalitarian control. Imagine that your access to life-saving surgeries or medicines are dependent on your compliance with UN policies. Also imagine who they might consider as mentally ill. Might it be those who pray to an unseen God, like Christians? We need to be prepared for all of these type of contingencies because I see them coming down the road. As we stated in the previous video, Gates and the WHO plan to tie the global health passports to your bank account in order for you to pay your carbon tax. Remember, climate change is a major premise of this initiative. Other taxes that they're suggesting in this document are a minimal global tax and something called a solidarity tax. They don't explain it. What is this solidarity tax? Imagine the thought leaders having totalitarian control over all these taxes and who has to pay them. Economies, as we now know them, are going to become a thing of the past. Also big on the list of to-dos for this new agenda is banks shifting investment away from the developed nations and to the developing world. Rich getting poorer, poor likely still staying poor, and the United Nations and the One World Government and the thought leaders becoming incredibly rich. That seems to be the plan. When we look back at the Bible, in Revelation 18, all sorts of wealth and riches stream into Mystery Babylon. Cargo of gold, silver, jewels, pearls, fine linen, purple, cloth, silk, scarlet cloth, all kinds of scented wood, all kinds of articles of ivory, all kinds of articles of costly wood, bronze, iron, and marble, cinnamon, spice, incense, myrrh, frankincense, wine, oil, fine flour, wheat, cattle, and sheep, horses and chariots, and slaves, that is, human souls. The wealth of the nations will be drained out of them and into the capital city of Mystery Babylon. Did you also notice that slavery will be a prominent feature of Mystery Babylon? Who will be the slaves? Well, we don't know, but we can assume it will be those who don't comply with the orders and laws of this new world order. Rather than imprison all of those who refuse to go along with the government, we wouldn't be surprised that some of us are turned into slaves of the government. Slavery is a long-standing human sin. Also, they will kill many of the righteous. Look at what Revelation 18 further says about this. And in her was found the blood of prophets and of saints and of all who have been slain on the earth. The word translated slain in this passage carries the idea of a sacrificial killing. Might this be part of satanic rituals? Maybe. We don't know, but it certainly sounds like it could be. And of course, Mideast peace will be big on their agenda as well. Who will the thought leaders favor in the ongoing struggle between Israel and the Palestinians? We don't need to ask. Will a peace accord be forced on Israel? Well, we don't know, but this is a very interesting question. Will there actually be nations that try to opt out of the one world government? Israel is a very likely choice for someone opting out because we're sure they will know that their national sovereignty is at stake. Another possibility is Russia, and yet another is China. In this previous video, we discussed that Vladimir Putin is very opposed to the one world government and one world control. A link to that previous video is here and down in the description as well. Is this also why the Antichrist armies invade Israel? Because they are not part of Mystery Babylon. And is it why in Daniel 11, the Antichrist receives distressing news from the north, Russia, and the east, China? But news from the east and the north shall alarm him, and he shall go out with great fury to destroy and devote many to destruction. But notice that the United States and the West isn't mentioned in this passage. The World Economic Forum slogan for recovering from the COVID pandemic is Build Back Better. Interesting. President Joe Biden's campaign slogan, and the slogan of his administration currently still is Build Back Better. Sounds the same, doesn't it? It's the same three words. And just in case those in the USA think this is a one-party problem, ask yourself which of the so-called conservative senators or leaders spoke about this new UN agenda. How many times have you heard about it from them? I haven't heard it at all. Likely because they are in on it too. Expect the USA to fold into Mystery Babylon. And now we have a date for it, 2023. And it could even be sooner. Consider how they moved the date from 2030 to 2023. And to some of you, I am sure the year 2023 caught your attention, you who have been watching the Middle East. It is the same year that Turkish President Erdogan wants to reconstruct the Ottoman Empire, which used to control much of the Middle East. And that reconstruction might not be peaceful. Why 2023? Well, 2023 is the 100th anniversary of the breakup of the Ottoman Empire. So 2023 could be a year of great unrest and the perfect time for an international coup, at the same time taking world power for the UN. It could also be the time when Satan's throne returns to Turkey. Click right here to learn what Satan's throne might be, why it was in Nazi Germany, where it's found in the Bible, and why it might be returning to Turkey in 2023. Till then, this is Nelson, and I'll see you there.